Welcome back, everybody. A pizza shop mystery solved. Tonight, we know why Vincent's Pizza Park on Ardmore Boulevard shut down. It is a landmark restaurant that has been around for generations. Sheldon Ingram now with what he has uncovered.
When customers showed up at Vincent's Pizza today, they couldn't get in and they could not get any pizza. But what they could get was a good look at this sheriff's sale sign announcing a sale of all of the equipment inside.
It's dark inside, and the ovens are cold. After nearly 60 years, no aroma, no pizza. But a lot of shock when people learn that Vincent's is shut down.
To find us out today and to see the lot empty is just it's surprising.
I was really like, oh my gosh, I can't believe a thing like this is coming to a close. I was little when that place, we used to go there when I was probably 6 years old.
And I know all of these people are devastated. Mm-hmm. Because it's a gathering place.
Just down the road, the owner of Beltrace Pizza is feeling the loss of Vincent's too. Jake O'Connor says the two were good-hearted rivals for 35 years before he bought Beltrace. Vincent's opened in 1953. O'Connor bought Beltrace 24 years ago.
I couldn't believe it. That place has been there since like 53.
Vincent's expanded with many franchises over the years. Court documents say Joseph Cava and John Bellissimo bought into Vincent's franchise but failed to pay royalties in full for the past year. Vincent sued, claiming a violation of the trademark. So now the Forest Hills shop is closed. The sheriff's sale includes ovens, tables, and even $485 in cash stored in a safe. A big loss for those who love the pizza for generations.
I know people that come back from out of state, and the first thing they come for is Vincent's Pizza.
A lot of people are happy with their pizza, and a lot of people will be unhappy to find out they won't be able to get it anymore.
In Forest Hills, Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.